Hi and welcome back to This Bytes For You. Today I have the pleasure of bringing you the announcement that AMD has released the 21.4 driver set for their video cards. Now, unlike most drivers that is just a performance increase in some games, cool 5 to however many percent, AMD is not only offering updated features, but new features as well. So come over here real quick and let's get started. Let me show you exactly what those features are. All right, so to start off with the features, right at the very beginning, AMD has updated their AMD Radeon Software installer with something people have been asking for quite some time. So if we go under additional options, install type, we see full factory reset, but under install type, we have minimal and drivers only. Drivers only, that way you guys don't run into some of the issues. Drivers only is pretty awesome because you don't need to install the AMD software suite. You can just install the drivers alone. This might help out a lot of you if you're running into any issues with the suite. The suite's awesome, but we all don't need it, right? But anyway, let me continue. So choosing the drivers only and of course factory reset option, we'll do a reset, cool, that works. Now factory reset, what it does, it resets your machine and then gives you a clean install path. That way you don't have all these other pieces of software running while it's installing and while it's removing all that good stuff. But we'll go ahead and skip ahead of this. Now, pay close attention here. Again, we're going to go to the second of the software suite's features. We're going to go under the minimal install. Now you have to pay close attention. Always select factory reset, but after restarting, right click on the desktop, AMD Radeon software, pay close attention here. We're going to have system, graphics, display, video, and preferences. This kind of looks similar, right? All right, let's move on to the next install. So coming back in after the uninstall, now we're going to select full install. And then of course, factory reset, and then we install. For AMD, Intel, NVIDIA, anybody, I always DDU the drivers first, come back into Windows. Then when I come back, I choose the custom and the full install. That way, if DDU didn't do something, the AMD, GeForce, Intel will take care of the rest. It's a great secondary option, but always keep that primary DDU, in my opinion. Just make sure you run it right. All right, so coming back into Windows, right click on the desktop, AMD Radeon software, and we're presented with what we've seen before, but notice the new stuff. So right here on this screen, there's a little slight changes, not much. Again, the current driver version 21.4 and pretty much everything we've seen before. Now going into gaming, we can see all the games I have installed, and then we can see a bunch of compatibility settings with those games or for those games, processor, video card, everything along those lines. Now, record and stream was not there under minimal. Here we're given the option to record or live stream, which was there before, but it's a little bit more streamlined. Hold on, I need to change something real quick. I'm at 1920 by 1080 on a huge monitor. All right, so coming back into the software and full screening it, we can get started or skip this. I'll do a quick get started recording. So now after clicking next, we can see some of the feature sets here and then some more on this screen. And then here we're done, we click finish and we're presented with a newer layout and then just a lot better way of setting it up. Live stream, back to record it again. We have a bunch of advanced settings. A lot of this has already been there, but they changed the UI a little bit to make it more user-friendly for you guys. So both recording and live streaming, performance, and then some preferences here. Under performance, here we have the metrics, and then we have some tuning for overclocking and all that good stuff there. Advisors, some of the settings advisors, and don't worry guys, we're getting into the good stuff in a second. Just some more of the compatibility stuff that we've already seen. Okay, so clicking on the gear over here, we have a bunch more features. Again, a lot of this will look familiar to you guys. But under graphics, you know, like I've shown you before, we have their anti-lag, boost, and FreeSync that reduces overall input latency, which helps a ton, and they've updated it as well. And then display. Now here we can see FreeSync. I have it disabled because I'm going through a capture card. Now under video, pretty much nothing new here. Then under hotkeys, a bunch of the different hotkeys. Now accounts, a bunch of the different accounts you can stream to. And then finally devices. Now this is where things start to get cool. Now you may have never used Link before. It's not new, but this is a new version. This is AMD Link 4.0. It gives you a bunch of cool features. I'm going to go over some of them now. So we'll go ahead and enable the AMD Link server. This machine becomes the Link server, allowed through the firewall. And now we'll go ahead and link a device. So AMD Link 4.0 has come a long way. Mind you, AMD Link has been there for a while. A lot of us never knew what it was, but I finally got a chance to play with it today, and it does a lot of cool stuff. Let me show you real quick. All right, so I am currently recording my screen. So now I go over here to the gear, and then I click on devices. Now here we can see I've already connected with my Pixel 5, but I'm going to show you like it was new. So first off, on my phone, I'm going to go to the Play Store and download AMD Link, and I already have it on here. So then on my device, I could click here, but I'm going to show you like it was new. I'll click link a device. Then on my phone, I'll click scan QR, and then I'll scan this over here. And now we're linked to the PC. So here you can see a bunch of the videos I've recorded before. I've tested this a lot, and then a bunch of the games installed. So I'm going to click on Shadow of the Tomb Raider and launch. Now we can see on my phone, there's a controller and then the background. Cool. So on here, I click play. I'm going to raise the volume on my phone. So like this was a controller for your console or for your PC, you can see it's moving and I'm clicking here. So I'm making all the changes here. I'm going to go ahead and continue where I was. Loading, loading, loading. So I'm looking around, you can see it here, and I'm controlling it all right here on my phone. You're not going to be able to see it too well, but all the changes I'm making on here are affecting that screen. So I could be in the bathroom. I could be sitting on the couch with my family watching a movie and... Oh, that was funny. Spending good quality family time. Now, they're going through the FMV both here and there, but obviously not a replacement for family time, but every once in a while you want a game, you might be away from your PC, and this is going to help you out a ton. But wait, there's more. All right, so I've exited out of my desktop from Shadow of the Tomb Raider. And unfortunately, I can't record while streaming. It doesn't want to work. So what you saw on my phone And actually what you saw in my background is what was happening. So, and I wasn't using my capture card at that time. But another cool thing you can do, let's say you have a PC somewhere out in the house that has a huge monitor and you don't want to lug your PC around or lug the monitor around. This works on the PC too. So I'm on the other side of my office. This is the PC I do all of my video editing on. I don't install games on here, but sometimes I want to play. Actually, I just thought of that. That's actually pretty cool. So on the screen now, and I can't do video recording and streaming at the same time unless I use maybe a separate app, but I'm just trying to stick to the AMD software suite. But over here, let me bring you in a little bit closer there. So if I come over here, let's say to the gear, and I click devices, actually this I'll record for you. Okay, I'm recording this beginning part for you. One thing I just remembered, I'll click on start, AMD Link for Windows. So that is also part of the software suite. Then over here we can see ThisBytesForYou PC, that PC over there. I click on it. This is everything that's on that PC. Since I was already playing Shadow of the Tomb Raider,
sure this is a path?
Come on, stay close to me.
This is definitely not a path. Oh God.
Almost there.
Almost there. Heard that before.
So that's pretty awesome, right? So aside from that feature, now one feature I cannot test. Actually, there's two I can't test. One feature I can't test, A, because I don't have those games, is the link part that sets up essentially LAN multiplayer games without, you know, they don't have to be in your same house, but, you know, so that you can play yourself, someone can connect to your computer and play with you, against you, or with you, as long as that game supports, you know, two players. So that's pretty awesome. Like, for example, NBA 2021. Again, I haven't tested it, so let me know down in the comments if you have and how it works. So another feature, unfortunately, I cannot test, because for this you require at least an AMD Radeon 6000 series card, the latest and greatest, is the AV1 decoder. Now, that is pretty awesome because as of right now, no AMD card supported. So this driver enables you or gives you support for AV1 decoding, and that's pretty sweet. But still, there's more. All right, so another cool feature that they've added to the software is the bug report tool. Now, this will open up if your game crashes or something along those lines. But, you know, if you see something weird, the game hasn't crashed, you can come over here and give all your features and specs and everything, and then report that. If they don't know there's an issue with something, they're not gonna fix it. So any issue you have, it's always best to report it for anybody. So that is a great feature as well. Now coming over here to display, we have an awesome feature. We'll go under custom resolutions, or actually, we'll go under color deficiency correction. All right, so this Protanopia allows for adjustment for people with red color blindness. So you can see not just one particular color grade, because if you don't know that you're red color blind and it looks off, this might help you on that. And then this one right over here, I'm not gonna try to butcher that, for green color blindness. And then this one over here for blue color blindness. So it's pretty awesome that they don't just go over a gradient scale and here, you figure it out. Mind you, I'm not saying that it's a bad thing that they're saying, here, go figure it out, when there's a color gradient and you get to select what looks better for you. But if you don't know you're red colorblind or blue colorblind or whatever, you set the color you think is good, and then your friend comes along. That looks horrible. Why does that look purple? That's not purple. That's orange. I don't know the spectrum, so I don't want to butcher that either, but I just want to give you an example of how that color blindness is not only cool because it's there, but it gives the software a greater reach for the community, and it allows for more people to be able to play, to have fun, or to do regular work. It allows more people to use the PC that they want, have their own personal experience. So that is pretty awesome. Now, mind you, I've discussed just about every single feature, if not every single feature. They've done an amazing job with the 21.4. And of course, this is just the beginning. Every day they're improving performance. And mind you, I did see a performance improvement, but it was really tiny. And I don't want to go over that because everybody else, let everyone else handle that. It was between 5 and like 8% what I saw. But anyway, I wanted to go over the bigger and better features. You can game on your PC, on your phone, on your tablet, on your laptop from your desktop. Old machine, you know, of course, you will need an AMD Radeon card, but it could be a really old card that doesn't do much. Now it can, as long as your desktop can. Then, you know, the color grading for people that have different kind of color blindness, the ability to mirror your PC onto a larger screen, and so many different things that they've added, AV1 decoder. AMD's really doing a ton. Let me know down below what your favorite feature is that they've added, and maybe let me know down below if there's a feature that they haven't added that you would like to add. Maybe they'll come around and look at that comment. Now, I've worked with AMD on this release, so definitely they're going to look. And of course, you can always submit that either in the Bug Report tool or in AMD's website. But don't forget, if you like this video, you want to see more of it, more like it, click like and subscribe. It'll help me out a ton, not only to make my channel grow, but to make companies like AMD and everybody see me, you know, and provide more stuff for me to bring to you guys. Anyway, that's about it for now. The 21.4 AMD driver set, and Iggy with ThisBytesForYou out. See you guys.